What's up, Nitro Nation? I remember the first time I ever seen that video by Tool Sober, I was like, what the F? WTF. And I'm still, when you see it, I'm like, what the F? That is the craziest video, man. But I like Tool. They're pretty badass. One of my favorite bands. And that song is fitting because the song is called Sober. And this marks it is 6 years that I have managed to stay sober and out of trouble. And I give the glory all to God, man. If it wasn't for Christ in my life, if it wasn't for God's mercy and His grace, I would be dead many times. I should not be here, okay? I'm a living testament that miracles do happen. I can tell you that firsthand. So, like I said, this is 6 years. I thank God and foremost the support of my mother that I love to death. You guys know how I am about my mom. I am a mama's boy, and I'm not afraid to admit it. Because if you look cross-eyed at my mom or my daughter or anybody in my family, I will whoop that ass. I will open up a can and spank that ass. Okay? So anyway, and my kids. My daughters, two beautiful daughters, Amber and Amy. They have been, you know, stuck with me through thick and thin. And it's cool because I'm out here. This is not the Nitro Cave, if you guys already noticed. This is my mom's computer room, but my daughter, younger daughter, turned it into her sewing room. She does all her seamstress stuff. She does a lot of cosplay, makes costumes and stuff like that. So, and now, since I've been here, this is going on my, third week now? Because, to make a long story short, my dad suffered a hernia, so he has a problem doing a lot of things and moving around. So my mom asked if I could stay out for a little while, but my dad actually said, can you stay a little bit longer, because I have a lot of things that I need you to help me with. Yeah, no problem, Pops, man. I mean, family is first, man. Family is first. God's first in my life. Then family. Then friends. And then me. I'm like last. But anyway, yeah, so I'm out here, and I'm like, I got all these goodies that I've been ordering. You guys know I've been talking about my fifth scale. It is finally here. I had to go pick it up back at the Nitro Cave. Plus, I picked up a bunch of other goodies. I've got probably at least another 20 boxes and packages back at the Nitro Cave. But we'll do unboxing of those next week when I get back, because I'm going to stay here another week. When I went back, took back the MBX5 Pro Spec, because we had an issue with the chassis still. But we will fix that again. I've got some brand new SOAR upgraded shocks, badass shocks for the Mugen MBX5 Pro Spec that we're going to upgrade. Plus, I must fix that chassis, but I'm still looking for a new chassis. And other than that, there's not really anything you need to do. It already has the bells and whistles, all of it, everything that comes with. So we just got to get it back in tip-top shape. So, meantime, I brought out, you know, even a better stand-in, should I call it, or substitute. This ain't no substitute for nothing. The Techno MB48.3 Buggy Modified Reds R5 Team Edition, sick to the sick ass modded engine. Okay, Triton 2148 pipe with the 41032 Novorossi header on here. Got the Badlands for it, which I'm going to switch these out. That's just in case I want to run it out in front of the parents' pad. But we're going to take that to the park. We're going to rip it. And if I have time, I'm not sure, I'm going to run the Mugen again. But instead of the RCR, the RCR modded 28.8, I might run the Pico, but I'm not sure. I might not be able to run this. So more than likely, the next running video you're going to see out here at the peeps at that park will be the Techno Buggy. So anyway, we got tons of goodies, people. We don't just got a next level fifth scale. We got a whole nother level, okay? When you see the fifth scale that I got in this box, a lot of people won't be surprised. A lot of people will be surprised. A lot of people will just be scratching their head and confused because they probably didn't see this coming. A lot of went into this. I did get a box of goodies. What I did is, since to speed up the process, I opened up a lot of these boxes of the goodies that I'm going to share with you guys, just so we don't have to, you know, waste time, so we can just get into the goodies and I can show you what I got. So we will start here at the end. And obviously we got, you know, without a doubt, the best fuel money can buy. Okay, if you want the best, you got to pay the extra cash. So Byron's 3011, that's all I use, that's all I've ever been using. I love this fuel, my favorite fuel. So Byron's 3011 kicks ass. Okay, so we've got a little bit of fuel there, but anyway, it's getting harder to find, man, and the hobby shops are still closed, so I got to pay a little bit extra. I'm paying like 12 bucks a quart, which I don't care, you know, so there you go. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 bucks for a gallon and a little bit over a gallon, plus tax and shipping. So I pay around 60 bucks for that stuff, so I don't mind. Like I said, it's the best fuel, so sometimes you got to pay the price. But anyway, first package we got here, I'm going to try to do. By the way, I am looking for a GoPro 2, I believe. Or there's a Sony one, I'm not sure. Oh, shout-outs, first of all, before we get all this started. Shout-outs to all the Nitro Maniacs, Buggy Maniacs, Truggy Maniacs, Fifth Scale, and Saniacs. And now that I'm becoming a Fifth Scale brother, this is my kind of my jump-in. And these two vehicles are here to welcome a new member to the... They're actually on top of the new member of the Muggy's family. And this new member is going to be the big brother, literally, because it's going to be way bigger than those things. So anyway, we'll put this box to this, we'll do this one last since this has Fisco goodies in it. Okay, this box here is from Amy. Oh, of course, people, gotta have them. I'm telling you, man. I don't know what you guys are waiting for, but pretty soon you won't be able to get these at all. There's not that many left, so I snatched up a few pairs for right now, because I gotta have Badlands. If I can't run my Truggies with anything other than Badlands, I don't even know what the hell I'm gonna run them with. So hopefully these Badlands will last me a long time. I've got, what, I've got two more pair in here, so that's six pairs that I have, and I'm gonna get maybe two more. I wanna get as many of these as I can. So we got the Badlands 1178. Don't roll your Truggy. If you guys aren't running these things, I don't know what you're waiting for. These are, without a doubt, no questions asked, no ifs, ands, or buts, the best 8-scale nitro Truggy tires, period, end of story. Nothing is better. Badlands. Badlands or nothing. That's the Muggy's theme. Badlands or nothing. Italian Indians or nothing. Byron's or nothing. Okay, there's another set. So we got one full set. What else do we... Oh, snap. Like I said, we got next level stuff coming. So why don't you guys hold on one second. Let me guys, I don't know where the heck... where's my stand? Oh, here, let me see if it's dry yet. I had to fix it. My stand broke, but anyway... I'm going to put you guys over here off to the side, and you guys should be able to see me right there. And we have here, this is from A-Main, I have a Reds Tetris Aluminum 4-Shoe Clutch 34mm. Oh, snaps. I love Reds. This is my second one. These are badass. I might change the shoes because I like two composites and two aluminum. I love these because for the simple fact that you don't have to really mess with springs. If you guys can see that, it has an adjustment to where you can get light in your springs, make your springs light, medium, or heavy. Yes, they are pricey. This little chingadera here is around 60 bucks, but again, where is it made? Where else? Italy, people. Italian or nothing. Okay, so that's that. We also have some of this. This is the most expensive tiny thing of grease that I've ever owned. And it better be damn good. I heard it's really good. We're going to try it. This is Huddy graphite grease. You're talking almost $10 for this thing. If you know what that Carmex lip balm for your chapped lips, that's about the size of it. But you don't need a lot of it, just a little bit. And this I'll use for gears. So when I'm putting together my discs, and I'll put a little bit of this around on the gearing. Also, I recommend when you set up your whip and you're doing your gear mesh on your spur and pinion, always whatever you want to use, use a little bit of grease. It just helps your gears last a little bit longer. Don't wear as quick. Now this here, we have here, let me take this out, because we want to see it. This is the Techno, super snap, look at that. Here, we got a, hell yeah. This is the M2C 48.3. There's my M2C stickers. You gotta take a closer look at this, people. This thing is a work of art. I am decided that I'm gonna do a full-on upgrade makeover to my Techno Truggy. And this is where I'm gonna start. This is 5 millimeter thick, so it's like a millimeter or two, twice the thickness of the stock. I like it because there's a few things that they change as far as the machining. It's pretty light. They cut this out. The stock chassis doesn't have this, which is for the spur gear to come through. This is all CNC machined aluminum, man. Look at that. This thing is sick. Look at that. Super snaps. There you go. M2C Racing Techno Truggy. Yeah, we are definitely going to carbon wrap this baby. There's no way in hell I'm going to get this thing scratched up. Bad asser. Badder asser, people. So that's that. And what do we got here? We have a Losi wheel. By the way, these do fit on the dynamite box. Part number. Bam. There you go. Fits on the dynamite box. I've also got a couple plugs that I highly recommend. For if you got Red's engines, there you go. Either the T3, TS3, or TS4, I use those. And the other one that I also use is the standard Novorossi. This is the C60GF Ultra. Ultra body medium. Good plugs. Because of the coating, see how it's black? Lasts a lot longer. Highly recommend those. So there's the chassis, there's that. Heady grease. Let's put this over here. Where are we at? 17 minutes. Let's get into the next giddy box. What do we have? Another box from A-Main. Oh, snap. What? Is that a 41032 Novorossi header? Only the baddest header for modified engines ever produced in the history of headers? Manifolds? Part number. There you go. There's that. And we have another one. Now, remember I mentioned that these are available. Their only place that has them right now is William Shore at Novorossi Direct. So this is the infamous 986, now known as the 51021 Super Strong Super Snapperoni. Not going to open it. No need to right now. You guys know what it looks like. So anyway, there's that. Oh, snaps. Got to have the DE Speedline Plus. You need a part number. Pause. black. Gotta have those. What else do we got? Oh, there's the rear, brand new rear diff housing for the Techno Truggy. I'm telling you, we're gonna rebuild that Truggy. And another pair. Oh, hell yeah. Another pair of Badlands 1178. So that's two pairs. Not one, but two pairs of Badlands. Those of you who've been around long enough, you remember the count on Sesame Street? Two pairs of Badlands. One pair of DE racing rims. So anyway, a bit of a Muggy's dry humor. Put that back in there, that back in there, and let's get on to the next box. Okay, let me set you guys down again since we're whirling all over the place. And we're going to see what is next on the list. Okay. Now next here, I believe this is my next level. Okay, we're going a whole nother level. Okay. On the... Where's my knife? Radios. So this is from Hobby King. Available, you're going to pay a little bit of extra money. You can get these for under $200, but I paid like $250 because I didn't want to wait a month to get it. I wanted it like now. So here it is. Bam! What is that? Is that the Fly Sky MB4 Noble Next Level Radio? Let's take a look at this bad boy. Oh, hell yeah! Look at that. Look at that box. That box is nice. Look at that, man. I'm talking, they know how to package their shit. This ain't no like Potato where they just throw it in the styrofoam or whatever. Look at that. Look at that. Quality, man. These people are, you know, they're going the extra mile. Oh, heck yeah. This is all the little goodie box. We got an extra grip. We got two. Are these wireless? Yeah, two wireless? I guess. Two wireless receivers. I thought they were going to give me a wired one, but two wireless receivers right here. Okay. That comes in that box. And then here is the radio. Man, that thing looks like a freaking laser gun. Choo, 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 choo. And here is the, what is this? The battery. Huh, that's pretty cool, huh? Look at that. And I believe this... By the way, if you want to see an unboxing of this, and let me give some shout-outs, too, mainly to the guys that are going to be helping me on my fifth-scale build. Shout-out to Elite RC and the 1/5 RC. Those guys have taken me under their wing for fifth-scale. Because the whip I have in that box down there, they both own them. So would only make sense for me to go to somebody that has the whip that I'm going to be running as far as fifth scale. So that's why they have agreed to help me on my fifth scale adventure. So there we go. So I guess I watched his video. He Elite is the one that recommended this radio.
Welcome to Noble.
Fly Sky, look at that. Looking pretty sexy. This thing has the same format as the IT4S. Man, I like it. But this thing feels solid, man. This thing is all solid aluminum. I believe you could change the colors, green, red, blue. Change the colors on top. This thing here, if you're left-handed, you can swivel it. This is all aluminum, people. This ain't no plastic. All aluminum. This is aluminum. This whole base, the battery's aluminum. The trigger is aluminum. Even this thing's aluminum. Billet aluminum, people. There ain't no plastic. I mean, there's plastic, but this ain't, you know, no cheapy radio here, man. This thing's pretty nice. I like it. I just like the way it feels. And the trigger. You can see the trigger in here. Let me push this on the other side, because I'm right-handed, so. But the trigger has an adjustment, so you can adjust it to your finger size. This is actually perfect for me. cool, man. It's got a setup for the kill switch. You can run RC boats on it. It's got all the setups. But this thing is rock solid, people. Look at the back of this thing. You can charge, you know, your USB. It has a charge for if you have a smartphone. You can charge it right in there. That's pretty cool, man. I dig it. 4,300 milliamps. Elite was saying this thing on a full charge, man. He doesn't even charge his, but every so often, man. It's a sick-looking radio. I like it, man. And it, like I said, man, this thing feels... It's solid. It's aluminum. A lot of aluminum on this thing, man. This is a badass radio. Highly recommend it. For around 200 bucks, you can't beat it. I think you can hook up like 9 cars to it. I mean, this thing has the menu on it is ridiculous because, I mean, you've got reverse, you've got EPA, subtrim, throttle drive, expedition steering, drive, ABS, assign, which, what is assign? Oh, wow, you can assign all the control assign, all the different buttons that are on the radio, like on the handles and all that stuff. You can assign it for different things. That's pretty sick, man. This thing's got all the goodies, people. Different models, whatever your model is going to be in here. You can, like I said, I think put 10 models or more. Sensors, these are for all your sensors. Choose sensors, speed, distance, system. This is for the system. I mean, look at that. Engine cutoff, there's your kill switch right there, people. For your kill switch, and you set it to however you want to set it. Brake mix, if you want to run a boat, there you go. There's your boat setup. Display, there's for all your servo. You can adjust where you want your servos to set, up to 4 servos. That's cool because I'm going to have 3 on my 5th scale. Mixers, idle up, idle down. And I'm not sure what that is. It's not, I don't know if you can change the color. I don't see the colors. It doesn't have the colors like the IT4S does, but nonetheless, this is pretty sick. I like it. I like it. Badder Asser radio. That thing just feels badass. Okay, we're at 25 minutes. All right, let's get on to the next goodies. Shutting down. Okay, matter of fact, we're going to get into the 5th scale goodies right now, people. Are you guys ready to see the Muggy's choice of 5th scale? Well, if you guys have been paying attention, and you see this pit mat that's on there, it should already tell you what my 5th scale is. So, let's put this back in here. Is that how it goes? Yeah. Oh, take this off, duh. Put the battery in there. I have to charge that later. Put this box in here. Yeah, I like this radio, man. This is my 5th scale radio. And I might use it on one of my other whips, I'm not sure. Or I might just use this for 5th scale only because I will be getting another 5th scale. Now, I will tell you, I want to give shout outs to the people that have been helping me and helping me make the decision on this 5th scale that I'm about to unbox. One I mentioned, Elite RC, the other one is Chris. 1/5 RC Garage, Chris San Pietro, I think that's how you say his name. He was a big influence on helping me pick out this. And you guys noticed this was also one of my goodies that I unboxed earlier. Oh, snaps. What is that? No way. What in the hell, Muggy? TLR Racing. Why would the Muggy have a TLR Racing and for a map? I don't understand. That doesn't make any sense, does it? What the hell would the Muggy be doing with a TLR mat? Well, we will soon find out. So we have some goodies. These are for my 5th scale. Let's move my buggy out of the way. Okay, you guys ready for this? Now, I'm going to put this on the ground. I'm going to put this up here so you can see how big this box is. This thing is huge. All right, people, you ready? As promised, I told you, man. This 5th scale, let me explain a few things. A lot of the reasons I picked this is, one of the main ones is they do not make this anymore. So good luck on finding one. One of my brothers did a video one time, and he even told everybody, don't be the reason. Don't wait and not get one of these, because you know how the company is, and you'll see what it is, and, you know, the company I'm talking about and the way they are. I don't, you know, the company that owns this platform here, or, you know, because it's not made anymore, they discontinued it. I don't like, okay? So without further ado, let's open her up. This is a whole nother level. Everybody out there in fifth scale is doing, you know, the RTRs. And what does the muggy always say? The RTRs, it's not a bad, it's just to learn, to cut your teeth. So why would I, if I'm going to get into fifth scale, get an RTR? That would go against the thing, everything that I believe in fifth scale. Right? Okay, so why would I? This whip makes perfect sense, you know, even though a lot of you guys are going to trip out and say, well, that doesn't make sense, Lucky, because you hate this company. I don't hate this manufacturer. I do not hate that company. I do not hate TLR. I hate the company that owns them, and TLR is dead. And what they did in cahoots with Horizon and kicking my boy Adam Drake, the legend, in the balls, and that's the reason that they went downhill. And that's why I always say Losi is dead. So the MBX, the Losi X Truggy, who knows when it's going to come out. Now with all this COVID-19, you might not see that thing till sometime next year, if that's when it comes out. So shout out to Dave, shout out to Steve, shout out to the other, who's the other lady that I talked to? I think her name is, it's on the box. What in the heck is her name? Oh, no, this is, it says, oh, I'm sorry. It says it on the box. I'm like, who the? Angela, Steve, Dave. Steve, I talked to you mostly. Steve was really helpful on getting this kit. Now, they might have some, but I doubt it, so... good luck on even finding this kit. Now I'm going to try to pull this out. I don't know how, because this thing is freaking huge. Let me turn it upside down, because I don't want to tear the box. And then, man, this thing is heavy. Jesus. Okay, this is one badass beast. And I talked to Sean at OVR. By the way, I will be getting an OVR full modified engine for this whip. It's being built as we speak. It's going to take about 2 months to build it because OBR is really busy right now. Damn, this thing's expensive. So, you guys ready? Are you ready to see what the muggy actually picked up? You're like, damn, muggy, get the hell out of the way. All right, and that's the reason I got this pit mat, because I have to have this pit mat because it goes with my whip. So, without further ado, da-da-da-da, the sickest batter-asser fifth scale, in my opinion, out there. Okay, now some people say, you know, they don't like when I talk about race kits. It is what it is. This is a race-inspired fifth scale. Do your homework, do your math, okay? This is the only fifth scale. There's one other one, which if you guys know, Vetka's, the Vetka Kraken, and there's the other one, that new truck that came out. I was thinking of getting that one. But I was talked out of it by not only DDM, Steve, I was talked out of it by Sean of OBR. Krakens are great if you got a lot of money in your pocket. They're a huge money pit. Okay, they're really heavy. They break, when you run them hard, they don't hold up. They're not designed to race, okay? This is the only vehicle that was designed to race. I mean, if you guys know anything about fifth scale, let me educate you. The 5B was the reason they came up with the fifth scale racing class, and it's the only fifth scale racing class that is designed around a specific vehicle. Not even the 5T. They didn't come up with a class of racing. Even though you race 5Ts, they built the class of racing for the 5B. This is a race kit, people. All right? This is no RTR. All right? So why would I buy an RTR? You know how the muggy is about RTRs. I gotta get a race kit, people. If you see this box right now, this camera doesn't do any... I don't even... There, let me put my... Let's put my Truggy. Because the Truggy is obviously bigger than the buggy. But we will compare. I'm going to do some comparisons because we're going to open it up and we're going to check out. I mean, the chassis on this thing is nasty. Disc brakes. It's got a aluminum center diff. The center diff cup is aluminum. I'm going to get front and rear aluminum diff cups as well because I think those are plastic. Dual steering servos. I've got three servos on the way. They should probably be here within the next week or so because they're coming overseas. They're going to take longer. I mean, it comes with an aluminum clutch carrier, center diff case. Look at the shocks. These are no RTR shocks, people. This is a 4.0 Losi Truggy, okay, on like 10 times steroids, okay? You know, that's if you look at this kit, and if those of you that already know that own one or have seen them in person, or anybody that has a 4.0 buggy, imagine your 4.0 Losi race buggy. That's what this is, six times the size. If, like I said, look at the box that it came in. If you can see this box right now, you guys would you could trip. I mean, look here. Let's put my MBX Mugen Truggy on top of it, and it's still. Compared to that thing, I mean, you guys can see that. Look, this Truggy, this thing farts bigger than this thing. It's a big whip, and you guys know, like I told you, Lead RC has one. You guys have seen his build. He's the only one that's built one. He already kind of had it built. I haven't seen anybody do an unboxing of this since I've been on YouTube, one kind of, but that's what I chose. I chose it because it is race-inspired. I could race it or I could bash it, okay? It's good either way. And there's not a lot you need to do to it. Even Elite, when I was talking to him, because you know how the muggy is. I want aluminum this, aluminum that. He says, you don't want to do that because they're already heavy. You want to keep them light. They're more agile. They're a lot quicker and faster. Once you start adding a bunch of aluminum, you weigh it down even more. The only problem with them, people will say, oh, they're overheating people. And it's funny, those people don't even own one. There's no overheating issue with these things as long as you cut out, ventilate the body right. That's the whole thing. Do your homework. Elite explained it to me. 1/5 Chris also explained to me too. Okay? You need to cut certain ventilations in it so it breathes better. And you won't have an overheating problem. So anyway, let me set this up here again so we can start taking some goodies out of here. Okay. My mom thinks that I'm freaking insane. Oh, look at that, people. Breaking the seals. Brand new sealed box. Never been opened. Oh, snaps. So, yeah, like I said, if I'm going to get into fishtail, we're going big or we'll go the hell home. So, we're going big. The engine that I have being built for this thing is going to cost me more than this thing. Oh, snaps! That's what I'm talking about, people. You ready? Let's go inside. Let's go in the box. Look at that body, man. That body's freaking... Look at the tires. Oh, my gosh. Here, we'll compare that tire to a freaking... Here, compare that to one of these. This is a AKA 8th scale... race tire. You ready? Here you go. Here's a Truggy tire. Here's a 5B buggy tire. That's insane. Look at that. Not even... That's funny, man. Look at that. Freaking huge, man. I'm super excited, people. This is a whole nother level. Oh, super snapperoni. Look at that. You gotta glue them, though. I don't think they come glued. Oh, they do come glued. What the hell? A lot of people tell me they don't come glued. Yeah, they come glued. Dang, because that's okay. I got a set of rims and tires coming for this thing. All right, so let's check out the body. Look at the body on this thing. Look at that. Here, we'll put it. We're putting this body on my Mugen. Look at that shit. This thing's huge, man. Oh, yeah, and you know how the muggy is, dude. This body is going to have a sick custom muggy maniac fresh body. We don't know what we're doing. We might do a Joker on there. We might do a Venom. I thought of Venom. You know, we might do something cool and something evil on that sucker. Okay, so that's the body. All right, what else do we got? What other kind of goodies? Oh, look at those freaking mud guards or those side rails. Those are huge. Okay, so what we're going to do is put this on the ground. Let's start taking parts out of here, and I'm going to lay them out and show them to you guys. So here's the tires. Yeah, there's the truggy tire. That's not even comparison. Okay, oh, snaps. Look at, there's another tire. There's the tires. Okay, now we have a TLR pit mat now. This is my TLR pit mat because I am officially a TLR guy. I don't want to say I'm a TLR guy, but hey, credit due where credit's due. I'm not stupid, man, and this thing is a badass whip. I had to have it. If I'm going to get into fifth scale, like I said, go big or go the hell home. There's the tires on that bad boy. Oh, yeah, this thing is freaking going to be huge, man. I can't wait to put this together. What else do we got here? This is 5B Race Kit Bag F. That looks like the radio tray. Oh, it's got that aluminum plate that goes on it. That's the radio tray. Oh, shit. Here is the tank. That looks like the tank. Yeah, see, we're going to build this thing, and I'm not even going to start building it for a while, so I'm sorry, people. Good news is I have it. Bad news is you guys are going to have blue balls. I've got a DDM aluminum, billet aluminum, two of them coming, a black one and a red one, because I'm not sure what color I'm going yet. Oh, no, I got black and silver, because it's universal. Cap coming for that. I've got all kinds of goodies, man. I'm spending a lot of money on this thing. If I'm going to build a fifth scale, even if it's my first, I'm going to go big and go hard. Look at that. Look at those freaking... Look at those TLR. I don't know what size those are. What are those? 20 millimeter? The aluminum? That's a big-ass aluminum... whatchamacallit? Wheel... Tire... you know what they're called. Look at that wing. That's the wing, people. Look at that big wing. That ain't no chicken wing, son. Okay, what else? What other goodies we got in here? We're going to show you all the goodies in this baby. What else we got in here? Oh, snap. Look at that. We got the bag C. That's the brace. What is that? Oh, dang, look at that. That's the spur gear. Got the spur gear in there. Center diff. Bag, whatever that is in there. It's in here. We got the, first thing I will put, oh, look at these shock bodies. Holy smokes. Look at those suckers, people. See on top? I got to see those from there. I got to open that. Where's my knife at? Where is my knife? Oh, there it is. I got to open that, people. I got to see that. Hold on. Spare. Hold on, people. Oh, look at that. That's a shock. Look at that, people. I don't got big hands, but look at that. That's probably a front shock. That ain't even the rear. Yep. There's the rear and the front. No, that's the rear and that's the front. Oh, here's the front. Billet, people. Billet. Billet aluminum. TLR racing shocks. Not no RTR bullshit. What else do we got here? Oh, that's a heavy bag here, whatever that is. That's all the arms, the bulkhead, the diffs. Oh, yeah, diff oil. 5,000. I don't think so. We're going to be running like freaking... Oh, that's for the shocks, maybe. We're running 100... we're running 1 million in the center, 500,000 in the front, 500,000 in the rear. That's where I was going. It was recommended. Another bag, more goodies in here. Jeez, look at those freaking arms, man. These arms are like, these are just the front arms. Look how monstrous those are. Here, let me show you one of these arms. See an arm. Look at that. That's a front arm right there, people. See that? Look at that. Look at that compared to a buggy, normal buggy arm. Here, that's the arm. 8-scale buggy? 5th-scale buggy. Anyway, that's that. More of the plates. Okay. Oh, here's the air cleaner. It even comes with an air cleaner. Cool. Fuel line. We got all that in there. We got, it comes with some tools. Yeah, we got a little lug wrench. Little lug wrench deal. Okay, nice. Now the big enchilada. Oh, shit. Look at that frame, people. Oh my god. Super snap-a-rooney. Look at that. Freaking. You guys see that? Look at that chassis. Look at that thing. Look how big it is, man. Look at this is the chassis, people. Compared to my buggy, look. This thing's like the size of a skateboard. This chassis, this is the size of like a 10-inch skateboard. Look at that. That's sick. I like it. Look at that. We should open it. Huh. Hold on. Hold on, people. Let's open it up. Oh, sorry about that. Look at that. Beautiful chip. Look at that. That thing is sick. Now that's what I'm talking about, people. Look at that. Race inspired, man. This is no RTR rookie newbie shit. I could have got a Baja. Yeah, I could have got, you know, a lot of vehicles. I didn't want a two-wheel drive. This is the only four-wheel drive fifth scale out there besides the LOC5T. And the LOC5T is an RTR too. This chassis and this kit, this buggy, if any of you guys have them, you don't do your research. This is nothing compared to the 5T. Completely different setup as far as next level. This is a whole nother level. Go ask Mr. Zah. He will tell you this is the only fifth scale that jumps even remotely close to an 8 scale nitro. Nothing else does but the 5B. Another reason that I got it, because I want to get as close to fifth scale as I can. Okay, what else? We got the manual in here. We got the 5B manual. Got some stickers. Okay, people, there it is. Oh, I got some other goodies. Where are they at? Okay, we got these goodies from DDM. We have a front aluminum top plate. That's going to be changed. There's the Losi Racing. These are like $40 a piece. There's an aluminum front here. We also got this here, which is the rear. No, this is the front aluminum chassis. And what else? Oops, I'm sorry. Where's my... Oh, I'm sorry. I have one other bag, and then we're going to end this video. We're already way over. We're almost an hour, and I told you it was going to be an hour. One more box to open from DDM. Okay. This is the last of my goodies. I'm going to put the camera down. Hold on, people. I know my camera work sucks, but I'm trying my best. Okay. All right. Sorry about that. Yep, we are going to get a GoPro. I'm working on it, people. Oh, snaps. Jaffa, here you go. A must. Jaffa aluminum skid plates. Recommended by 1/5 RC and recommended by Elite. They both have them. Badass. These things are thick, man. Nice and thick. These are going to be my protecting the bottom of my chassis. Nice freaking skid plate. Love it. And here we go. Bartolone Racing, people. We got the Bartolone Racing